grateful and I'm very happy to receive it in the name of the hungry, of the naked, of the homeless, of the crippled, of the blind, of the lepers, of all those people who feel unwanted, unloved, uncared, thrown away of the society.
That abortion has become the greatest destroyer of peace. We are afraid of the nucleus because it is touching us. But we are not afraid. The mother is not afraid to commit that terrible murder. Even when God himself speaks of that, he says, even if mother could forget her child, I will not forget you. I have carved you on the palm of my hand. You are precious to me. I love you. These are God's own words to you, to me, to that little unborn child. And this is, if we really want peace, if we are sincere in our hearts that we really want peace, today, let us make the strong resolution that in our country, in our cities, we will not allow a single child to feel unwanted. How does peace come? Through works of love. I want to give tender love and care to the people.
Love must be put into action, works of love and works of peace, to make them feel wanted, loved, cared. They are some of this. They are Jesus in the distress in these guys.
Jesus is in the
from the very beginning, I wanted to serve the poor purely for the love of God and to give them what the rich people get with money. I wanted to give to the poor for the love of God. That's the spirit of our society. That's total surrender, loving trust, and cheerfulness. We must be able to radiate the joy of Christ, which is expressed in our actions. If our actions are just actions by themselves, without giving that joy to the people, our poor people will never be able to rise up to the call which we want them to have. That means to come closer to God. Also to help us, and he's still with us, Dr. Sen, who has been also training our sisters for the leprosy work, because he's a specialist in the leprosy work. Here, in the slums, in Yirmujidon, in the children, we see Christ in the broken body, and we touch him. And that touch comes from the deep faith that Christ cannot deceive. Faith is the gift of God. Eh? Without it, there would be no life. And our work to be fruitful and to be all for God and beautiful has to be built on that faith. Faith in Christ, that he has said, I was hungry, I was naked, I was sick, and I was homeless, and you did it to me. On this, his words, all our work is based and built on. In these times of development, everybody's in a hurry and everybody's in a rush. But on the way, there are always people falling on the two sides, those who are not able. These are the ones that we want to love, serve, and take up and take care of them.